So today I'm going to be showing you my entire Dior bag collection. Hi my loves, welcome back. I thought it was time for a collection video. It's been ages since I've done one. And also, I was looking back at my videos and I think it's been over 3 years since I've shown you an updated Dior collection. Now, my Dior collection hasn't grown that much, but there's definitely new bags that I've added. And I'm just loving what Dior are doing so much the past few years. And I thought it was about time I show you my collection. So for those of you that are new here, hi, I'm Mel. Don't forget to click the subscribe button, join our family, and don't forget to join part two of my giveaway, which is still running. I think by the time this video goes live, there might only be 5 or 6 days left, so make sure you join that, but I still have a part three coming. Okay, so in this video, I'm gonna be showing you the bags, I think from oldest to my newest, and of course, I will show you mod shots. For reference, I am 164 centimeters tall, so about 5'4 or 5'5. So let's get to the very first bag. So first up is one of my favorites, and it is this vintage Dior clutch. Now this clutch is from the 1970s. I picked this up in an auction here in Melbourne in a very prestigious auction house, and I got it for such a steal. I don't even remember how long I've had this for, at least 10 years, and I just love it so much. It's still so on trend and I love that it's vintage. So to open it up, you just pull it open like this. It's got this really cool mechanism, and inside, no pockets or anything, it's just one compartment, but it does actually fit quite a lot. It has the Dior oblique monogram, and then this is trimmed in black leather. And for a piece being like over 40 years old, it's probably like, I'm not exactly sure from the 70s when, but over 40 years old, it is in such good condition, like pristine. There is a little bit of yellowing along here, but you can't really tell. So I think for those of you that have always wanted to add a monogram piece, you don't need to worry because it will stand the test of time, because I don't foresee Dior changing their logo anytime soon. So that is my very first piece. Okay, the next bag is actually a mini one, and it is also in the Dior oblique print. And this one here, I got, I don't even know, I think maybe nine years ago. Again, it was such a great deal. I think I picked this up for under 200 Australian dollars. And this time it is in the burgundy. So Dior, again, the burgundy print was released ages ago. If you guys want to look on the pre-loved market and on the vintage market, you absolutely can find some gems. This one here does have a bit more discoloration here, but it's not that obvious. When I bought this bag, it did have that discoloration, but you can't really see. Now, as you can see here, it is very flat, so you can't fit a lot in here, but I just really liked it. I thought it was so cute at the time, before the mini bag trend took off. I love this sort of thin, delicate chain, and sometimes I even wear it as a belt bag. All I do is I loop one of my other chain belts through, and you can wear it as a belt bag. It's sort of like a mini wok, but you can't fit that much in. Nevertheless, I do still really like it. I think it's really cute, and yeah, I just love vintage pieces, and I love vintage Dior pieces, and I definitely would hunt down some more. So the next bag I have to show you is a forever classic. You cannot go wrong if you want to buy this bag. And I'm talking about the Lady Dior. Now, for all my OG subscribers, you guys would know this was probably one of the first few unboxings that I did. I got this back in 2016, and I just loved the black and the silver combination. I think this is such an elegant bag. It is timeless, the canage print. It's in lambskin. So this is back when they still had the zipper top. Nowadays, you don't have the zipper top, it's a flap top. And the criticism was that it is a little bit hard to get in and out of, but after a while, it does loosen up. Now, the reason why I loved this particular one was that this was sort of like a limited one because it did come with a limited edition strap. So that is the jeweled strap that it came with. And I just loved it when I saw it. I still remember the campaign that Marion Cotillard, I think, was in, and she just looks so chic. And yeah, you couldn't buy this strap separately. Nowadays with Dior, you can buy a lot of their straps separately, but this came with this bag. And so later on, I actually could order one of their shoulder straps. So the traditional Lady Dior just comes with this shoulder strap, which you can't cross body. It's just meant to be worn as a shoulder bag or as a handheld bag. So inside the bag, it is all in, I'm not sure if you guys can see, but red lining, red leather lining, and it's also got one internal zip pocket. I forgot to mention that this is the medium size, and I specifically wanted a medium for my first Lady Dior because I think that's just the most iconic size, and you know, Princess Diana looks so elegant in it. I go into more of the history and everything about the Lady Dior when I did this unboxing video. I will link it above if you want to go back and see my unboxing from 2016, but I still love it just as much today. And it's just a bag that is just so iconic Dior. You know, one thing about Dior the last few years is that they have brought out a lot of bags and then they've discontinued them. I will go into that a little bit later with my bags, but you can be sure that they're not going to discontinue this Lady Dior because yeah, it is just so synonymous with the Maison. So the next bag is a bag I got for my birthday in 2017, and it is the iconic indigo blue Jardio flap bag. Now this bag has been discontinued. I remember when it was launched, it was so popular. It came in this style, it came in a wallet on chain, it came with like a thicker leather crossbody strap. The one that I chose has this detachable chain, and even all the links here has CD on it, which I actually really, really like. One of the really cool things about this bag is that you can slot your hand through like this and also use it as a clutch. That was a very edgy way of wearing it. I hadn't seen any bag in the market that kind of did that. So it was a very, very popular bag. And also I specifically picked this indigo blue because that was the color of the season. Like I remember all the Dior windows that were blue and the visual merchandising was just spectacular. Now this bag here, I have to admit, I have not used it for a while. It is in just perfect condition. It is made in this calfskin leather. It is a smooth leather, but it's not that delicate. It's actually held up really well from 2017. If you open the bag up, it's just a magnetic clasp like this. Inside, it's lined in this beautiful indigo suede. Inside, take that out. Inside, there are a couple of slip pockets made in beautiful soft leather and another slip pocket here. So it's a pretty roomy bag, and it was so popular that I think even the Dior Revolution around that time, very similar, I didn't say Jardio, but just Dior, that was really popular too, but now those lines have been discontinued. So if you did want to get this bag now, you would have to look in the pre-loved market. As I was saying before, this is probably my least used Dior bag out of my entire collection. I think with flap bags, I just tend to go more for my Chanel flap bags if I'm going for a flap bag. And so this one here, I know you guys have been asking me for ages and ages to have a vlog sale, and I have been meaning to, but I just really, really like to think about things before I sell them. And I may be having one in the future, but this was one I've been thinking for at least a year or so now. But if any of you were interested in this beautiful Jadio flat bag, please do email me. My email is askmelonmelbourne@gmail.com. Please, I just ask serious inquiries only. It is in perfect condition. There is not one single scratch on this bag. Yeah, you know me. I just really like to look after my babies. And I still like it. It's not that I don't like it, but I think if I'm going to try and let go slowly, I just have to, you know, it's a process for me. Sometimes I just like to keep all my bags, but I'm trying, guys. So this beautiful indigo baby is up for sale. And yes, I will ship worldwide, though I do prefer Australian buyers if you were interested. So that is my Jadio flat bag. So have you noticed that I'm kind of wearing, I'm all decked out in Dior today. I have got a Dior necklace on, I've got Dior earrings, I've got my Dior pearl ring, and I've got a Dior headband. Now this is actually not a Dior headband, but I thought it was so cool just to use my Dior Twilly and wrap it around. What I'll do is I'll do like a shorts video or like a 30 second video how you can do it, because you can transform it into this and it's so easy, and you can do it with like with your Fendi or your LV or your Hermes scarves, and it's just a really quick way of getting that kind of look without the price tag. Okay, so moving along, let's go to this bag here. Now this bag here, again, is another bag that Dior discontinued. I'm actually not sure why they discontinued this bag, because I think it is such a classic silhouette, and this is actually called the Dior Addict flat bag. Now, it's got the same chains as the Jadio, where all the links, on every single link, it's got a CD, which I love that little detailing. It is removable so that, you know, you can use this as a clutch. Now, with this one, to open it up, you just push this lock and it opens up, and inside's lined in beautiful gray suede. And inside the bag, again, it's a similar layout to the Jadio in that it's got a couple of slip pockets, but this one's got a zip pocket here. Now this one does fit a little bit less than the Jadio, but it does fit all my essentials. And this bag, I actually still really like. So this one here was actually inspired by another Dior bag from, you know, years ago as well. I can't remember what that was called, but this bag here came in, you know, the leather, it came in the Dior oblique, it came in so many different sizes, and I still really like this. I like this flap style. So this one's not going anywhere. I don't mind that it's discontinued. I think it is a great bag. Oh yes, it also comes with the little key, which you could lock this up, but you don't really lock it up anyway. But I'm still really enjoy this bag, and I just think it's in a beautiful shade of gray as well. Next up is, I think this was around the same time, I can't remember, but definitely in, I think mid or early 2018, I got the Dior book tote. Now, I got this when they released it, and the price was much more reasonable. And I remember getting it from a personal shopper, because at that time when they released this, oh my gosh, there was such a huge waiting list. And this is the large version. Back then they only had the large. They didn't have the small or the mini version. So I picked the Dior oblique, the Dior monogram, because as I said, this monogram is never going to go out of style. Again, this is a bag I don't use that much, but I do like having it in my collection. The Dior book tote, the last few years, just been getting more and more popular. That's why you see, you know, the Maison releasing different colors, different sizes. Every single season, there's like a new print. I am so in love with the Toile de Jouy one. I've still been deliberating whether I should add the pink one in small to my collection. The small is definitely more manageable day to day. This is a pretty good size for travel, but again, none of us have been traveling, but I do still really like it. I also wear this as a shoulder bag when I do wear it sometimes, because if you do put a lot of things in there, it can get really heavy. So inside here, I've just got my insert, and if you're wondering, yes, this is a 7RP insert. They do make inserts for Dior book totes as well. You guys know my love for 7RP, but yes, my exclusive and highest discount code is still available. So if you've got a Dior book tote, this is just the perfect insert for it. I'll leave my codes down below. But yes, this Dior Book Tote, I remember when I got it, yeah, it was just such a good price. I think now, from the price I got it back then to what it is now, it's gone up like 70%. I know, that's how much it's increased in price. So that is my biggest Dior bag and I still love her. So next up is a bag that is another vintage beauty. And I can't remember if I picked this up before the Dior Book Tote, but I think it was around the same time. It was sort of mid 2018. They had not released the Dior saddle in store yet. So guys, this is a vintage saddle bag and I got this for such a great price. I remember, and I think I've mentioned this in a video before when I, you know, unboxed this, before anyone knew that the Dior saddles were coming back, they were just everywhere in the secondhand market. You could have picked them up for $100 USD or $200 USD. It was just ridiculous. So because I was looking out for it, I managed to get mine, which is in absolutely immaculate vintage condition. The previous owner, I think, hardly used it. It came with the authenticity card, the original dust bag, everything. And I actually found this on Etsy and I think I paid less than $400 Australian for it. So glad to have bought this when I did, before it got into stores. That's how I was able to score this at such a good price. I wish now I bought another one because I was eyeing a denim one and I wish I had got that, but still I am grateful that I have this one. Now this one here is different from the current version because it's got the Velcro opening, and inside, look, it doesn't fit a lot, but it does fit your essentials, and most importantly, it does fit a phone. It's just all in sort of like a nylon fabric interior with a zip pocket here. Now, if you guys watched my, you know, best and worst bags, you will know that my kids hate this bag. Both of them put this as their worst bag in my entire collection. And I was like, hey guys, that's a bit harsh, but I get it. It's not a bag for everyone because of the unique sort of shape. It's often referred to as, you know, a kidney bean bag or something. And, but I just think it's really cool. And I don't know, I just really like it. And the next bag I have to show you is this plush little cutie. So this is the Lady Dior, but it is in the mini size and it is in gray velvet. How cute is she? Again, you guys know that I love adding different fabrications to my collection. And besides my Gucci Marmont, which by the way, I still own and I'm not selling, I still love the color. But when my SA showed me this bag, I was just sold. I love that this Dior, the little embellishments have the, you know, little diamantes. I think they call it the Dior Strauss. And yeah, it is just so cute. So it's, this one does have the flap. And this one has the handle. This is the handle that comes with it. So the chain handle, which is not adjustable, but it is really comfortable because it has this leather bit there. And I do own quite a few Dior Twillies. Obviously, this is not my entire Dior collection, but my favorite Twillies from the house definitely are their, you know, floral themed ones. Again, Mel loves floral. And this one, I can't remember what it's called, but it's something jardin, some garden or something. But it, look how nice it looks on this velvet baby. I would actually consider adding the in-between size, which is the ABC Dior or the small Lady Dior, because as you can see, this is the medium and this is the mini. So there is an in-between size. Actually, there is another size it comes in. It comes in the large as well. And if I was to get the large, I would probably go the vintage route, but I definitely wanted a mini. It's great for an evening bag. It's just too cute. And the newest bag, which I added to my collection, is this gorgeous Lady Dior, well, the Dior Daylight. And this is the same size as my black one, but it is all in fabric. Now, I love floral, as you know, and this was the Lunar New Year Hibiscus Limited Edition. Oh, I forgot to tell you, I got my little mini grey one at the start of 2020. So this one here, yes, yeah, start of 2021, I got this. I just love the embroidery, all the gold through it, bit of Lurex. I just think it is such a stunning bag and it goes with heaps of my floral dresses. Again, this one does have the flap opening and inside it does have the thicker shoulder strap. So this strap, you know, if I wanted, I would use this on other bags as well. Look how beautiful the embroidered strap is. It is just stunning. And you could even wear it this way as well if you wanted. Yeah, I just really love this strap and this is much more comfortable if you wanted to crossbody it. But honestly, I think that with Lady Dior's, they look more elegant handheld or on the shoulder. But, you know, of course it's nice to have the option to crossbody. This one here is in a very light gold and I wanted that because my black one has the silver. And even this one here, I think this one, yes, it is a silver, but it's a little bit different because it has the, you know, little diamantes on there. So I have to admit, my love for Lady Dior has just grown and grown. I actually would love to add even more. I think the Lady Dior is definitely my favorite. It's the most classic, and I love that every season they come out in different patterns, different leathers. It even came in shearling, which I thought was so cute. If you guys have been thinking of adding a Dior bag to your collection, my recommendation would be to add the Lady Dior in whatever size, you know, you feel comfortable with, but I don't think you can go wrong. So that is my latest bag, but I have one to show you. And that's why I also wanted to do this Dior collection video, because I picked up another one and it is vintage. I found it on eBay. It was through a private seller, but because for me, I kind of know my Dior bags. I'm not an authenticator or anything. And yes, I did get it authenticated. I saw this bag and I just saw the potential. So let me reveal to you my newest baby. Dun, dun, dun. I think it's gonna show very blown out, but this is another Lady Dior. It is vintage, but what makes this so special, and I'll do a close up, is that it is a limited edition. So this one here, it still has the zipper. It is in cream leather. And this one here, it's got a plaque and it says Dior Limited Edition. What does it say? Dior Limited Edition 541. So they obviously made a certain number of these bags. I'm guessing maybe 1,000. I don't know. It could be 600. I'm not sure. But I loved this because, again, Mel loves lace. And I'll do a close-up, but the detailing on here, what they've done is laser cut all the leather so that it resembles sort of like Chantilly lace. And it is just so intricate. Now this bag here, you probably can't tell, but it does have, you know, quite a bit of yellowing, like certain areas have yellowed. And there is like here, the leather has sort of yellowed with age. So I can't say it's in the best condition. But when I was looking for this, the most important thing to me was that the laser cut was not damaged. Because what I'm thinking for this bag is that I could get it restored or I could get it re-dyed to a cream color or even a different color if I wanted. But for now, I'm just gonna enjoy using it as is because it's almost discolored quite evenly, if you know what I mean. So another way that it looks beautiful is, look, I've just put a Dior mitzvah on there and it completely changes the look of the bag up. I love this. I probably need to get another one of these for the other side. And this one just has the silver hardware, but I just couldn't get over the lace. And again, guys, I got this for such a steal. So I bought this for $600 Australian. So I couldn't believe it because it is still, there's actually no corner wear on this. It's just that it's yellowed with age because it is a vintage bag. So What do you think? I just think it was really worth it. I know when people, it looked much worse in the listing, but also my recommendation is if you see a private seller, don't be afraid to ask them for extra pictures. Don't be afraid to negotiate price with them because you never know. Because this bag was actually listed higher and I had said to her, would you accept this amount? And then we negotiated to a price that we were both happy with. And I'm thrilled with this bag. Yes, she needs a little bit of TLC, but I don't mind. I don't mind at all. And it's another vintage beauty to add, not only to my vintage bag collection, but to my Dior collection. So that is it, guys. That is my entire Dior collection. Do I have other wishlist Dior bags? Probably yes, but I'm really happy with my collection at the moment. Comment below, what was your favorite bag from my collection? I would love to know. And don't forget to enter the giveaway. So thank you all so much for watching. Have a fabulous day, stay safe, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye, guys.